You might know how to analyze a project. You might know how to read their tokenomics, but how exactly do you find these different projects that are releasing? In this video, I'm going to go over exactly that. Now, finding projects early is the key to getting exclusive access to their different token sales or securing the different airdrops that they're doing. So it's very important that you're finding these projects early. The earlier that you're getting in, the more whitelist or allocations or airdrops that you can get for that project. A lot of times, if a project is in the later stage and closer to mint, a lot more people are paying attention and you're not going to be able to get a whitelist nearly as easy. Now, there's all these projects that are constantly releasing in the space and it's very hard to actually keep up with them. And to make matters worse, guys, there's all these different blockchains and ecosystems. And if you spread yourself too thin, you're going to end up having worse performance. So in my opinion, you're better off sticking to just a few blockchains where you can be a master at them and really know that space and ecosystem rather than trying to do too much. Now, the first way and my favorite way to actually find out about these different plays is to join some sort of alpha group or community. We have ours called Jelly Cubes. And in these different alpha groups, you have Discords, Telegrams, whatever the case is, Twitter spaces, where you're able to, as a community, look for all these investments and opportunities. Trying to find all of this yourself is just not going to work out. You need to be part of some group and community. There are a decent amount of free alpha groups out there, some ranging in quality and some requiring you to be an active participant. And then there's other alpha groups such as Jelly Cubes, where if you own one of our Jelly Cube NFTs, you get access to our Discord, the community, and all of the alpha that we have in the group. The next thing you can use is Twitter, aka X. A lot of very serious crypto traders and degens are actually using X, and it has a wealth of information. Now, it can be hard sorting through all this information, but what I do is I'd find accounts that you really like and trust. I would click on the three dots, add them to a list such as a Solana list, a Bitcoin list, a Cardano list, whatever the case is. And then once you have a really good list, you can click on those different lists and now you'll see posts only from those different accounts. And this can be a really great way of staying up to date on information and finding projects early. You can also use the search bar feature at the top where you can look up things such as new ETH NFT mint or upcoming airdrop, these different keywords, and they have all these different filters and maybe you can find some great accounts that way. There's also X spaces where different communities and projects will go on these spaces. They'll talk about the alpha. They'll talk about what they're paying attention to. And this is a really great way to not only network, but meet different people in the community and stay up to date on projects. Another useful tip as well is you can actually look at who these different people or projects are following, and then you can follow those projects. And then once you do that, now all of a sudden you can really build up those different lists. And now all of a sudden you'll have like a domino effect of finding project after project. And that's where you have to be good at analyzing to see if it's actually worth your time to spend on those projects. Telegram is another social platform that people have been using to keep up to date with different news and releases. Most of the time, these Telegram groups are for shit coins or meme coins, but they can be pretty helpful still. And it's a great way to network. A lot of times I would just join these different Telegrams that are for new meme coins. And then you can network in there, talk to a couple people, and they might put you into some sort of shill group. Just be aware that a lot of them are just trying to dump their bag on you. So don't just buy anything you see and do your own research. The final place that's good for getting information is actually YouTube. There's a lot of really great YouTubers out there that are a great resource to just learn about the space more. But as you learn more on YouTube, you'll find that a lot of the information out there is more basic and more standard rather than really getting into the nitty gritty of these different projects. You'll really find the serious investors and the serious information over on Twitter or over on Discord or Telegram, but YouTube is still a really great resource. And I know for my channel, Jason Borg, I try my best to go into detail about some of these newer releases and my personal analysis. Now realize, guys, that it takes a lot longer to make a YouTube video than it does for someone to simply put a tweet or Discord post. And that's why it's important to actually join these communities if you're serious about investing in the space. That pretty much wraps up how you can find new projects and stay up to date on the space. The biggest recommendation is just spending that time figuring out the right accounts to follow, following them, and then every day or at least every couple of days or at least at the minimum every week, go through some of these posts and see what's happening.